Hello everyone to the Canadian Museum for Human Rights. My name is Yashila and I'm here to deliver another visit of one of the galleries of the museum. We heard from last time from Kali's tour, you liked the tour, so I am here again today to give you another tour of one of the galleries of the museum. So we'll start by looking at the name of the architect of the museum engraved in the alabaster stone. His name is Antoine Prédoc, and he is a world-renowned American architect from Albuquerque, New Mexico. His design of the museum was very much inspired by the Canadian landscape, but also the design of the museum is very symbolic of human rights. One of the places that we'll be visiting today is the Israel Asper Tower of Hope that you will get to see at the end of this tour. But for now, we'll be heading in one of the galleries of the museum on level 7 that we call Inspiring Change. Please follow me. So here we are on level 7 in the gallery that we call Inspiring Change. And you'll see how the gallery is full of colors and light, because now we're looking about how across Canada and throughout the world, how people are coming together to make a difference using actions, using their imagination, and how they're trying to inspire others. And you'll be looking at all the stories in here, how they are very inspiring stories. One of them that we'll be looking together today, it's called Grandmothers in Solidarity. In a lot of countries in Africa, grandmothers have to take care of their grandchildren because those children, their parents, have passed away from AIDS. And the Stephen Lewis Foundation had a campaign in 2006 to help these grandmothers. Today, more than 204 grandmothers group have come together to talk about AIDS and to try to provide support for these grandmothers in the countries in Africa. One of the projects that that had lots of attention during the World AIDS Day in 2012 is the tree. And this tree has been yarn bombed by the grandmothers in South Africa. And this is to talk a little bit about how we are trying to give some hope and commemoration of those who have died of AIDS. We can see right here, there is an image of the grandmothers actually yarn bombing the jacaranda tree in front of the Hillcrest Center of AIDS in South Africa. So we can see that these colors in itself on the tree is trying to be is a symbol of hope. And how today we are going through a health crisis, and we are seeing how people throughout the world in our community are using music and paintings to try to inspire other people and to give hope to people around the world. So now we'll be going to a special place in this gallery, so follow me. So here we are in the special place, a section that talks a little bit about music and human rights. And very often, a lot of visitors, they miss this part of the gallery. But this is all about how artists and people fighting for human rights and have been inspired by stories of human rights around the world have created music and written music. And here we have a screen where you can actually touch to listen to a huge selection of songs that we have about music and human rights. And you could also use our headphones to listen to it in the galleries. So we can see through art and music how we can inspire all other people around the world. So now we'll be going to another spot in this place that we call joining the conversation. So here we are on a wall which has a lot of colors of cards, and we know that you cannot physically be in the museum today, but we are going through a period of time where we have to stay home, and perhaps you want to tell us something, you want to share something with us. So for example, here we have a card that says, "I imagine a world without hunger and racism. Dream of love, freedom of speech and love. No more orphans, trust in humanity." So if you want to leave a comment or share your story with us, you can always leave us a comment on our Facebook page. I would love to read those comments. So now we'll be heading to a very nice place, the Israel Asper Tower of Hope. So there it is, the spiral staircase of 108 steps. You could always use them to go up to the Israel Asper Tower of Hope. But if you're a little bit just like me, that's a little scared of heights, we will be taking the elevators. Follow me, please. There we are in the Israel Asper Tower of Hope, a 360-degree view of a beautiful city, Winnipeg. And you will be seeing how the tower is full of light. It's just a very inspiring place to be. And today we'll be visiting a few areas of the city that has had a lot of stories of human rights. In the meanwhile, please enjoy the view. So to the east of the city, we have Saint Boniface, where Louis Riel, the Métis leader, he's resting. And you could also see how the river is melting. We are in spring right now. And if we move a little bit to the south of the city, we have the Forks, which is a national historic site. And this is a place where for thousands of years, indigenous people from across North America came right here to live. To the west of the city, we have Main Street, where in 1919, during the Winnipeg General Strike, we had around 35,000 people that came together to open the dialogue and conversation about improving labor rights. A little bit to the north of the city, we have Exchange District, where a lot of events took place there, but one of them would be that in Canada, women did not have the right to vote or was even not legally recognized as being people. Until 1916, Manitoba opened up and gave some groups of women the right to vote. So here we are at the end of our visit, and I hope you really liked it. If you would like to watch the video again or to share it with a friend, please visit our website humanrights.ca, or if you want to share a story also, you could go on humanrights.ca/share your story. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.